Hi guys, welcome to Now Kids, welcome to Sunday. Hope you have a fantastic time with our programme today. This week we're looking at week three of our topic on truth, and it's all about being kind when you disagree. Now we know that in life we'll disagree with people about things, we'll have different ideas and different opinions, but the point today is just to make sure that when we do disagree with people, we make sure that we're kind and we're respectful to one another. Colossians 4:6 says, "Let your conversations be always full of grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone." Have a great day. Bye.
Hey everyone, welcome to Connect.
Tony.
And I'm Mike. Welcome to Connect.
It's great to see you.
But before we get started, there's a few rules we have to go over.
The rules make sure everyone stays safe and has a great time.
First up is rule number one.
Listen to your small group leader. Respect them and obey what they tell you to do.
The grown-ups are here to help you and keep you safe.
Next up, it's rule number two.
Be a good friend. Treat others the way you want to be treated.
And don't just stop there. Treat others the way Jesus treated other people. Use kind words and show love and respect to everyone.
And be on the lookout for people that may be joining us for the first time. Be a good friend to them too.
Now that's two rules down. That means it's time for rule number three.
And it's my favorite rule. Have fun!
Having fun really is the best part.
Now that we've gone through the three rules,
it's time for the silent arm wave. I'll start, Tony, you finish. Ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Guess what time it is?
Offering time!
I love giving back to God with my tithes and offerings.
So does Erica. She writes to us to say,
I love giving every week at church, but sometimes I wonder, what does God's money get used for?
Oh man, Erica, there's all sorts of ways our tithes and offerings get used. It goes directly to help God's plan.
God uses your offering to help with all the things He's doing in the world.
Sometimes what we give goes to help build churches in our neighborhood and around the world.
That means more places where kids and adults can hear about Jesus.
Sometimes what we give goes to helping people during times in their life when they really need God to provide for them.
That means giving people help in our city and across the globe during big and small disasters.
Sometimes what we give is used to share the Bible with people who have never had the chance to read it.
With apps and technology, we're able to reach others like never before.
The money we give as offering becomes a part of all that.
Pretty exciting, isn't it? Thanks for your question, Erica, and thanks for giving.
Because giving is a great way to
reach others
and put God first.
5 seconds, max.
Do you really think it'll be that fast?
I know it.
Okay, you ready?
Ready.
1, 2, 3. Maurice! Wow, Maurice, I think you're getting faster at that.
Yeah? What was my time?
Oh, man. I hit the wrong button. Could you do it again? Please?
Sure, let's do it.
Okay.
Ow!
We are ConnectHQ.
Every day, we help the people of the world
live God's way.
We look for the links,
make the connection,
and you never know what might happen.
My name's Maurice, and this is the time I learned how to disagree respectfully. So what do you guys think?
Those are some great-looking tools, Maurice. You should be proud. What am I supposed to say? I don't know a thing about tools.
Oh, well, these aren't mine. Remember my sister Clarice? Well, her daughter, Denise, my niece, is joining the Tech and Tools group today. These are for her.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Are you excited to start working with your niece?
Oh, absolutely. She was always small and shy as a kid, but she was always interested in building things and curious as to what tool did what. I think there's a lot that I'm going to be able to teach her.
Uncle Maurice!
Denise, hey! I almost didn't recognize you. Wow, you've gotten taller.
Yeah, I went through a last-minute growth spurt as I was finishing up school, which ended up giving my confidence a big-time boost. How are you?
I'm great. I'm glad that you're here. Oh, this is Tony and Dot. They work at HQ, too.
Hi. So great to meet you both.
It is great to meet you, too.
Would you like us to give you a tour of the building?
Actually, I thought it might be a good idea if we went over the regulations that we're going to be...
Hey, looks like we've got our first call. Why don't you show me the ropes on the job? Come on, Uncle Maurice.
Sure, yeah. Right down this way to the hub. Looks like the console's on the fritz again. Last time this happened, it took me a good 6 hours before I got it up and running. Okay. So, first thing that we should do is we should figure out what's working and what's not. Then we can follow all the wires and...
There.
What did you do?
It was just an unplugged cable. If only all fixes were that easy. Am I right?
Yeah. Great job, Denise. Only, in the future, maybe let me show you how I do things. I have a lot that I can teach you, you know?
For sure. That's why I wanted to work with you. I knew we could learn a lot from each other. Since that call went so quickly, I might take Dot up on that tour, if that's okay?
Yeah, sure.
It's not exactly what you imagined whenever you thought about working with your niece, huh?
No kidding. She handled that call so different than I would have.
But it sounded like she still respected you, even though you had a different way of doing things. And that's what's important. It's okay to disagree, just do so respectfully.
It's okay to disagree, just do so respectfully.
My brothers helped me learn early on that there's always going to be people that we disagree with, and that's okay. What's important is that we show God's love no matter what.
You're right. Thanks, Tony. I can go get the paperwork ready. There's so much that I can teach her about paperwork.
Sounds great.
And once you have all your receipts, then you can fill out this paperwork. And it's really important that you fill out this paperwork before you fill out all the other paperwork. Does that make sense?
Yes, I think I'm following.
I understand that it's a lot to figure out, but that's okay. I'll be with you every step of the way. Also, be sure you complete each form in black ink by hand. Why don't you try filling out this form here?
Sure. Sure thing.
How do you think Denise is doing?
Well, I think we got off to a rough start. But now that we've spent a little bit more time with each other, I think we're getting to figure things out. I don't think paperwork is going to come naturally, too. Denise? I thought you were going to start on the paperwork.
Look, All of those forms are available on this app.
What? That's so cool!
It gets better. The app remembers your information and carries it over from form to form. Uncle Maurice, this app should cut down on the time you spend on paperwork each week by half, at least. Isn't it awesome?
Yeah, that's great, Denise.
I'll have all this paperwork done in no time.
Hey, Maurice, how's Denise doing?
I'm not sure. I mean, she's obviously a really smart, really nice kid, but when her mom and I were kids, we were always trying to boss each other around. You know, she would want to do things her way, I would want to do things my way, and we spent so much time just bickering and arguing, and I feel like I'm doing the same thing with Denise now.
You know what? I think I have a verse that could help you out. You want to say it with me?
Sure.
Okay. So it's from the book of Colossians, chapter 4, verse 6. It goes like this. Colossians 4, 6.
Colossians 4, 6.
Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt.
Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt.
So that you may know how to answer everyone.
So that you may know how to answer everyone.
It's okay to have disagreements with some people. It could be a family member, it could be a friend, or it could be someone that really, really reminds you of your sister. But we can tell them about our thoughts and our feelings as long as we use words that show kindness, love, respect, and grace.
So I can tell Denise I'd like it if we did it my way, so long as I use good words.
Yeah, exactly.
I can do that. You know, I think I'll go walk her through how to make a call to Connect customer service. You know how tricky it can be to order parts from them.
I've heard a thing or two.
All right. Good words. Good words. I can do this.
Hey, whenever I get done here, I'll come check on you guys.
Oh, that'd be great. I told you to talk to Marcia.
They told me Marcia doesn't work today, so I talked to Rachel instead.
Rachel? Rachel doesn't have anything to do with the parts department.
I figured that out, but I thought she might be able to point me in the right direction.
I was pointing you in the right direction.
We're not actually pointing me in the right direction.
Is this how we want to handle this disagreement?
Oh, sorry. I didn't realize anyone else was here. I can go.
First days can be rough.
I know. I just didn't expect the trouble to come from my Uncle Maurice. Feels like he thinks everything I do is wrong.
One thing I've learned working here at Connect HQ is that we're all different people, and we all have different ways of doing things. And those differences aren't bad. But sometimes we don't always see eye to eye.
What do you think I should do? I don't want to have fights all the time.
Here's some do's I figured out from the many times I've disagreed with my brother. Do ask the other person to share their own thoughts and listen respectfully. Do share your own thoughts honestly. Do be ready to learn something new. Do talk to a trusted adult if you ever feel confused or stressed. And do ask God to help you speak loving words and listen with a humble heart.
I think it might be a good idea for me to pray right now.
That's a great idea.
God, thank you so much for the chance to work at Connect HQ with my Uncle Maurice. I pray that you would help us figure out how to show love to each other, even if we don't agree. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. How do you feel? A little better?
Yes. Thank you so much for all your help, Dot.
You're welcome.
I messed up, didn't I?
A little bit, yeah.
I thought that if I just used kind words to explain my side of things, that she'd see that my way was better. But she didn't. And then we started fighting.
Well, here's the thing. We don't use kind words and show God's love to get people to come around to our way of thinking. It's not our job to prove someone wrong or to change them, no matter what we disagree about.
Even if you know your way is right?
No matter what, Even if someone doesn't believe in Jesus, it's our job to love everyone, to pray for them, and to trust that God's working within their hearts.
I guess the only time things are different is when the disagreement is causing someone to get hurt.
Exactly. In that situation, it's our job to step in, tell them to stop. And if you're a kid, to go get help from a trusted adult immediately.
Still, I guess sometimes disagreements just can't be fixed. They just are.
And that's okay.
Hey, Denise.
Hey, Maurice.
I think the two of you would have something that you'd like to say?
Sorry.
No. Go ahead.
Why don't we watch this video from the archives? It might help get things started.
This is the story about the God who loves us in the Bible. We find truth and purpose to love God and love others. We're searching God's word for things to discover. This book is alive, full of answers and godly advice. This book is alive. See the wonderful stories inside. Every day I'm searching, read through history and poetry. How much Jesus loves me. God's great story lives. There's no other book like this. This book is alive.
When we follow Jesus, we live the way the Bible says to. That pleases God. But what if other people who are following Jesus and living to please God make different choices? Who's wrong? Who's right? The people in New Testament Bible times wanted to know this too. When the Apostle Paul wrote a letter to the first Christians living in the city of Rome, he told them not to argue with each other about what they thought was right or wrong. For instance, the Roman Christians disagreed about what was right to eat. Some people wanted to follow the Old Testament rules about food to please God. But others believed that as long as you thank God for the food, it shouldn't matter. Paul told them to handle it this way. Don't let it bother you and stop trying to boss people around who don't agree with you. Paul said to let God be the one to speak to others about what pleases him and what doesn't. So, however we live, we should do it to honor God. We belong to him, and we should try to do things his way, even if that seems different from how other people do.
Even the people who follow Jesus in the Bible had disagreements sometimes, but from them, we can learn that if we stay respectful and make choices that honor each other, we can disagree in good ways.
And always trust that God is working within both of your hearts.
Listen, I'm sorry, Denise.
I'm sorry too, Maurice. I know you have so much knowledge about the work we do here. I should have taken more time to listen to you.
And I should have been more open to your new ideas. I think that if we work together, we're gonna make a great team. Hey there, my name is Maurice, and I'm a part of Connect HQ. I learned a verse today, and I'd really like to share it with you. It goes like this, Colossians 4:6. Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone. When you're talking with someone that you disagree with, it's important to make sure that you use words that show kindness, love, respect, and grace. Jesus' followers disagreed sometimes in the Bible. But they figured out that when we stay respectful and make choices that honor each other, we can still love one another. All of us have disagreements sometimes, and that's okay. We just need to remember the do's and don'ts of disagreeing. Do ask the other person to share their thoughts and listen respectfully. Do share your own thoughts honestly. Talk to a trusted adult if you feel confused or stressed. And ask God to help you speak loving words and listen with a humble heart. Don't try to change the other person, call them names, hate them, or forget about them. If you follow those do's and don'ts and trust God to continue working on both of your hearts, then you can keep loving the other person even if they disagree. Don't forget, it's okay to disagree. Just do so respectfully. And remember, ConnectHQ is here to help you.
Believe it or not, I'm not the best singer or dancer in the world. Maybe you are, or maybe you're not either. But guess what? We can still worship God with our singing and dancing. Worship isn't about how good we are, it's about how good God is. And I know that God loves it whenever we connect to Him together at church. So sing loud and dance for Him with all you've got. Let's get up on our feet and let's connect with God together.
is a hammer.
I know that one.
Pliers?
Huh. I always thought they were called rub pliers.
Phillip's head screwdriver.
Phillip must have had a really interestingly shaped head.
And wrench.
Hammer. Pliers. Phillip's head screwdriver and wrench.
You got it.
When we disagree with someone else, it isn't always easy to know how to act or what to do next. But God is always with us and He wants to help us. If you've never made the choice to follow Jesus, make Him your leader and your number one friend, you can do that right now. All you have to remember are the ABCs.
A, admit. Admit that you've done wrong and ask God to forgive you for disobeying Him. B, believe. Believe God sent Jesus to take the punishment for your sin. Trust that you are forgiven because Jesus made you right with God. C, choose. Choose to spend your whole life depending on God's power to help you say no to sin. As you live and love like Jesus, tell others God is your leader and number one friend.
Did you make that choice today? If so, be sure to talk about it with a parent or a leader you trust.
Hi now, kids.
Hi.
Welcome to our game of Would You Rather for activity time today.
It is going to be awesome. Mm. I cannot wait.
So today I've chosen to play with Amber. And everyone says that we're really, really similar. So we'll see when we choose our Would You Rather things in there, if we've got the same ideas or different, and let's see how we handle it. Okay, let's go.
Let's go. Right, are you going to pick first or shall I? Don't look.
Right then. Would you rather have a magic carpet that flies or a personal robot of your own?
Oh, man. I think I'd go for the robot.
Okay, why?
Just because then I could get the robot to do so much more. I could get the robot to drive me somewhere. I could get the robot to like make me a drink. I could get the robot to make me some food. I'll get the robot to just, I don't know, do everything with, rather than having a magic carpet. It's all right, but it only does one thing, doesn't it? It's not going to be like...
Yeah, well, I'm going to go for the magic carpet.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, I'm going to go for the magic carpet because the magic carpet can get me anywhere and I don't have to do the driving. I don't have to go on a plane and buy a ticket. I can go anywhere and I can put other people on there as well.
Yeah, so that is good.
I'm going to go for that. So that's the first thing we disagree on. Okay.
Right, let's go for another one.
I haven't slapped her or anything yet, so.
Right, oh, this one's a good one. So, would you rather wear a clown wig or a clown nose forever? Forever? No! I don't want to wear it forever. Do you have to wear the clown wig forever as well?
Yeah, it's a clown wig forever or a clown nose forever.
Oh. I feel like if you wore the clown nose, you could just not look at people, and then when you turn around, they're going to see the clown nose, but they're not going to notice you walking like to school with the clown hair. But I feel like if you had the clown hair, and people see you, they're just going to be like, whoa, what's some crazy red hair going on? But I feel like you could just hide, especially now with masks. You could get a humongous mask and put it over the top of your nose, and it's not a problem. So I think I'm going to go for the clown nose.
Do you know what I'm going to go for? I'm going to go for the special lockdown clown hair. Because then I don't ever have to go to the hairdresser.
That's a good point.
Okay, we disagreed again, but we're still okay. Everyone's smiling. That's good. Right, let's see. Oh, would you rather live without TV or a mobile phone?
I feel like a TV. No, I feel like a mobile phone. Oh, that's the wrong one then.
Okay, no, you changed your mind.
Yeah, I can't change my mind because I didn't mean to say that.
Oh, okay.
I would rather live without my mobile phone just because... Oh, this is a hard one though because I'm thinking about all the games that I've got on my phone.
Oh gosh, the games, yeah.
So I like playing a lot of games on my phone and I feel like TV, you could just do endless stuff on a TV. Do you know what I mean? You can watch loads, but then I guess on a mobile phone, you could also watch TV and have everything on your phone.
Yeah.
So maybe I'd give up the TV after all.
I'm going to agree with you here, actually. I'm going to say give up the TV because not for the purposes of watching and whatever, but I don't think I could bear going anywhere without being able to call in an emergency. It's a proper mum answer. That is.
To be fair, I think if I got lost somewhere, I'd probably ring you and be like, but if I got the phone, then...
It's okay, because I can then watch TV.
Exactly. I just watch TV, get my TV out of the car.
Okay,
is it my game?
Yeah.
Right. Oh, this is a good one. So, would you rather be an Olympic athlete or prime minister?
I'm going to go for Olympic athlete.
Okay.
Because I feel like you can travel the world.
Yeah.
You can be brilliant. You can use the gifts you've been given. Yeah, I feel like an Olympic athlete.
I agree with you. I don't want to be prime minister. I feel like that's too much responsibility.
Yeah.
Man, and you're not be able to travel and take an holiday. You can't just watch like a TV show when you want.
Yeah.
You just got to always be on schedule. I suppose, like, obviously you can't not do anything in life without being on schedule. But I definitely think an Olympic athlete will be so much better than a prime minister.
Yes, that is true. Right, okay, let's see where we're at now then.
She's a good one.
Oh, would you rather be the worst player on a team who always wins, maybe just, you know, a fluke, or the best player who always loses? So the person who always wins is the worst player. No one likes them. They're not very good. It's just by chance every time, or cheating or something, that they always win, or be the best player who everybody loves and you're ace and awesome, but you never ever win.
I don't know, you know, because I don't obviously want to be a loser and they're always winning by all the time by cheating.
Yeah.
But I don't want to be the best player and then never win.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
It is hard.
I feel like I'd rather be the best player and never win.
Yeah.
Than cheat and everything on the other side. But
yeah.
I don't know, it's a hard one. It's a hard one.
Well, you've got to choose. You've got to choose. And I'm not saying mine
first. Right, okay, I feel like I'm going to go for best player.
Yeah. I think, right, and I'm going to be completely honest here, I would go for best player.
Yeah.
But I feel like Amber would go for the win. She'd go for the win.
Do you know what?
She'd like in her heart to say, I'd always be the, you know, play fairly and everyone takes part, but Amber is in it to win it.
That is true. I am in it to win it and I would like to say that, but I don't know. You'll have to test me on it.
Yeah, so we'll have to leave that one because I don't think she was quite thinking really there.
I was. Right, I'm going to do mine now. Would you rather have three legs or three arms?
Gonna go for three arms.
Me
because
too.
Then I can just do everything quicker because today, for example, I've needed three knees, never mind three arms. So I'm gonna go for three arms.
Do you know what? I agree with you. I feel like three legs, one of them's gonna get in the way. You're not gonna be able to walk properly. Think about it. You're trying to walk up and down the stairs and your legs just get in the way. You're tripping over yourself.
Yeah.
You can't get into like a car easily.
Wait, you've got to find a third shoe when everything's sold in pairs. That would not be good.
You've got to find some trousers that fit you. One leg's gonna be naked. You have to put some jeans on and then you're gonna have to get like some more jeans, but cut it out and put a single leg.
That's weird.
I don't mind that.
Three arms, yep. It is.
Three arms.
Right. Okay, then. So, would you want to, also, would you rather always announce your name loudly when coming into a room? Hello, it's Michelle. Like that. Or do cartwheels every time you left a room?
Oh, that's so hard.
Yeah.
So I feel like those would be so cool.
Yeah, well, would it be cool? You get to church, you're a bit late, everything's started. Marcus is doing like a really serious talk on something that's really important. And then in you come, hello.
Can you imagine everyone turn around and be like, shut up.
Or you could be in a situation where it's pretty quiet. Maybe people, you've been in your classroom, people have like got really telling off because they've not been sensible, or the class has got called out.
Yeah. I don't even know which one. Oh, I don't know. I feel like the loudness is me. So I'm going to come into a room and be like, hello, and it doesn't matter what anyone else is doing. But I feel like the cartwheels, that is such a cool way to go out of the room. Do you know what I mean? You go like, you can put some spy music on or put some like celebration music on. You just go leave that room in style. Yeah,
no, you can't. You've just got to randomly cartwheel.
So
you
can't get any background music. I'm just taking like a little CD player or speaker with me.
No, you can't
like,
do that.
Play.
I'm gonna go for the say my name. I can't do cartwheels, so that's no good for me.
I feel like I'm gonna do the cartwheels. I feel like that is way cooler than the hello.
Yeah.
You only get one shot at that, but you get like 5 or 6 different cartwheels before you actually leave the room.
Okay. I think we've only got, I'm checking on the time, we've got 1 minute left.
Okay, right, okay. One more.
1 minute.
Oh my gosh. Right, so would you rather crawl on all fours or walk backwards?
Oh my goodness.
Go.
Let's see how you get on down the stairs though, Amber. Oh, this is looking a bit dangerous. Don't try this at home, kids.
Please do not try this at home. Feels so nervous. I don't like not seeing behind. I'm like, I'm
really set. Well, you can't turn around, remember. Oh. You've got to keep going backwards.
Oh man, okay, bye. So after examining how I'm gonna do this, I think I'm gonna have to go with crawl on all fours. I don't like walking backwards. I feel like I'm gonna trip backwards. You don't know what's behind you. I don't feel like your friends are gonna be nice enough to say watch out. They'll just like fall. That's it. So I feel like crawling on all fours is my decision. What's
okay,
yours?
I'm gonna go for walking backwards.
Oh yeah.
I absolutely don't want to walk backwards, but the thought of putting my hands on the floor.
Yeah, no, but you can put some gloves on.
No, I'm just not doing it.
No,
not happening. In a muddy field, can you imagine that? No.
I think that's actually pretty gross. I just won't walk outside. I think that's the solution to all of this. Just don't go outside, problem solved.
I think we've got time for one more.
Okay.
One
right.
More then.
Go on then. Choose.
Choose. That's a rubbish one. I'm going to do that as a final one. I'm going to choose this one. Oh.
What is it?
Would you rather drink sour milk or eat rotten eggs?
You are joking.
I don't know what to say about this. Because,
I feel sick already. I feel like
are going to be sick either way. Whatever happens. And do you know what I'm going to go for? I'm going to put myself out there. I'm going to say sour milk.
I'm going to say sour milk.
I think that's safest.
I feel like that's safest. I feel like a rotten egg, I wouldn't be able to put it anywhere near my mouth. At least with the sour milk.
Yeah.
I'd just stop smelling.
Yeah.
And I'd just drink it.
Yeah.
Whereas the rotten egg, I could see it.
Yeah.
I could... Ooh, yeah. No. Yeah. I feel like it's going to be rotten milk.
Yeah.
Rotten milk.
Rotten milk.
Rotten milk. Rotten milk. No, sour milk.
Okay, so we've run out of time now. That's it. We've got no more time to be doing these, and I think me and Amber might go carry on and play this for a few more.
I think we're
going
to have to, because this is a pretty good game.
But the main thing to remember is sometimes we agreed, didn't we? Sometimes, we get on really well anyway, so we knew that we'd have similar answers to some things. But the main thing is that when we did disagree, we did it respectfully.
Yeah,
and that's the point, isn't it, from today. So I hope you have enjoyed our Would You Rather game. A little bit different to what we've done. And now it is probably time for game time.
Hi-ho, hi-ho. It's home from work we go. Hi-ho, 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 hi-ho. It's home from work we go.
Salagadoola, metrigaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Put them together and what have you got? Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Salagadoola, metrigaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell me.
the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea.
Build a snowman. Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies. And now...
No, 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 no.
Tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go.
You'll be rewarded when at last I am given my dues. And injustice deliciously square. Be prepared.
Yeah, be prepared. Yeah, we'll be prepared.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come.
Oh,
to
Roger.
See her is to take a sudden chill. Cruella, Cruella, she's like a spider waiting for the kill.
Roger,
look
she'll
out.
Hear you.
For the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities or Mother Nature's recipes.
Top two or three, I'm on the job.
You big nay, Bob.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend.
One jump ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can't afford. That's everything. One jump ahead of the lawmen, that's all, and that's no joke. These guys don't appreciate I'm pro.
Don't you derogate or deride. You're in my world now, not your world. And I got friends on the other side.
Celebrate.
on the sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands.
Born of cold and winter air and mountain rain combining, this icy force, both foul and fair, has a frozen harbor lining.
Still they glee. Yes, I'd rather be called deadly, for my killer show too medley. Psycho, cause way down deep inside I've got a dream.
He's got a dream, he's got a dream.